So tonight, what I got in mind is we're going to do another part of the graphic that you watched me do last time. In the previous video, I did a composite using this program right here. It's PD Howler. What you saw is I did some graphics that had text in them and then one that was like a background. I combined them in this program and we did some cover art for my song The Dream album. I've gotten most of my work together for another record called Crucible, and I'll put a link up to it here, so if you want to go listen to it you can. I got it up on Reverb Nation right now. All right. And we're doing it again, drawing on the same layer. Stop that. Right, so drawing on this layer. There. Kind of coming through a little bit clearer too, right? Okay, I think we got to do that crushing type there. Start this one over. Like having the T like block style. Not so good either. There. I wonder if I've worn out my nib. I don't think so. Feeling pretty fat. Something more like that, right? All right. I'm going to keep that one. We'll just kind of turn it down a little bit. Just kind of keep it in the background. Make another one here. That I like. Do one more. I'll kind of put it on top of each other. You turn this one off. Ah, I don't know if I like that. Still, I think so maybe what I'd like to do here is we'll do one more layer. We'll turn this one down. Kind of move it more towards center. Oops. I might do one more just because I'm getting an idea here. Structure. A little bit bigger. move that over a little bit. Ah. Ooh, I'm kind of liking that. Kind of do an arc shape right there. Turn this one off. Just take it down a little bit further. Oops. Kind of cartoony, right? We're kind of creeping back over to the side there, but I can fix that. There's a nice way to make the So we're thinking about. I'd like to get maybe the tin closer together. All right, that one I like. So what we're gonna do is drop this all down to one layer. Let's look at all those layers you made right there. Drop it down to one, that's correct. Oh no! I should have turned them all off rather than on. That's unfortunate, because there is no undo. Yes, there is. Look at that. Okay. And it did what I wanted. That's crazy. So what we're going to do is try to clean that up a little bit. That looks pretty cool. I think we need to move that eye over though. So I think what I'd like to do is actually collapse that down, because that's a really good model. I like it, so let's kind of try to put some 3D effect on it now. I'll add a layer for that. Now, I do it dark. Really size it up. Oh, that's not what I wanted. That's the one. So I want to draw these lines, you know, without using any of the tools or anything, just to give it kind of more of a natural look. That I am not perfect, nor should my art be, unless I can make it perfect personally. And I don't suppose it'll ever be perfect to me, right? You can get into something and continue to work on it indefinitely. Turn off the one before it there. Well, that's the problem. You're drawing it on the wrong layer. That's kind of cool how it flipped over like that. But what I don't understand is what's the color I selected. Oh, okay. Let's just do another layer here. So I like what I'm looking at right there. I'll just turn down the. This one. There we go. I don't like that. kind of thinking about how to make this smooth curve. All right. I think we got one more that'll kind of show the shading for it. I don't think that's a good guide. All right. So let's paint it. Maybe we'll just get rid of these other layers now because I don't need them. Oops. I can hit undo there. There we go. Can do maybe is just get rid of these. All right. You might like this playlist, when I've got on, kinda, I like to get lost in just listening to music and drawing. It seems like I can get into this space where none of the stress in the world even gets to me at all. It's not on my mind anywhere. I can just think about the task at hand and how I want something to look. I think we'll do this like a two-tone. So I'm going to use this just for this front face, this color. And we'll use, oh, maybe three tones, right? For the sides, I'll do one color, maybe a little bit darker. And then for the top, something a little bit lighter. So I hope everything is going very well in your world. And if it's not, maybe I can help you imagine a better one. And you can know part of the game of imagination, right, is actualizing the image or just letting one flow out of you and just roll with it. All right. Go a little darker. So I hope one day I'll be kind of good at this and it'll be something. The images I make are really leaving people feeling a sense of wonder. Who was this madman? When we think of that color scheme, in that first letter there will serve as a template for the color scheme. There's something just about applying the color that really makes it stand out. I like even watching it go on. It's just something interesting to watch, right? So kind of take it to right there. Hit this one too. And then put a line right there. There we go. Let's make that full screen here. So I'm wondering if we should keep the same color scheme on the bottom one as we have on the top one here. I think we should. Or you know what? We can try it on a different one here. So if you don't like it, you can change it. Because what I want to do, I'll put the... There we go. Let's get in there nice and tight. It's much easier not to go between the lines. It'd be interesting to see how this one looks. Lost in the color. I hope you are too. I wonder if I'll see comments about me not talking very much, but I think I'm done with like just saying idle things. If I speak, it's really because I have some things, you know, I want to share. Oh, no. You did it on another... But you will. Sorry. We've got Def Leppard's Stage Fright playing here. So I think it's an extraordinarily cool way to spend the evening. Let's see how this looks. I think I like it going with just the two tones. And I like the lighter one and the darker one. Oops. So I wonder, for any of you who come across this video and make it this far in there, just leave a comment. Let me know who your favorite band is. And what your favorite song is by them. I think that would be a cool thing to talk about. I like to think I'm a pretty big music fan. Right, so what we're gonna do here, I guess we'll just I think I'm gonna fix the that top of the eye while I'm at it here too. So I got a little queen up on deck. So I'm going to the movie soundtracks. That was probably one of my favorites, was when Queen did the music for Flash Gordon. I like superheroes a lot. And a lot of times it's, you know, that musical theme that they have kind of makes them that much cooler, right? And I think that face looks good. Oh. So I'm following Queen up with Death Clock going to the water. I actually really like their guitar work, especially on this song. I know they're supposed to be like a parody band, but that doesn't mean the music isn't good. Go. Let's have a look now. I think that looks pretty cool. I wonder if we should just paint those in. Or maybe with a lighter. What do you think of that? I'm gonna kind of fix this little area right here. It is bothering me. There we go. All right. So before we save it then, let's mix it down. Now I'll export it. What's cool about this program too, you saw it on the last video, is you can do like this cutout thing right here. You make it any size you want. Right, and now it's just kind of operates more like a PNG. I kind of fix some of the nice, right? So I'm just gonna check that. Yeah, I like it. All right, well, thanks for joining me, and we'll see you in the next one.